Greetings. It's me again. Well, anyway, back to this discussion. We're really talking about the ape monkey. We stem from the monkeys 40 million years ago, from the apes who charted off away from them 25 million years ago, and then thusly the humanoids, human erectus and all of that. So anyway, so here we are. And here's some watermelon, okay? And I'm wondering how the monkey ate the watermelon. Because we had the mangoes. Now this is understanding. Now when you go back and you just eat the mango diet and you have, you know, for one meal, that's just like a monkey hitting that tree, like the ape hitting that tree, going in for those mangoes. Or you're going for the bananas. You know, it's just you going in there and taking it. You're using your hands, dexterous, using your hands to peel that banana. Okay. So then I'm like, well, yes, that's true. So we have easy fruit for 40 million to 25 million, that's 15 million years of easy fruit. And then from the 25 million to when the humans started upright away from Neanderthal. Okay, so when we started upright away from Neanderthal, that's most recent, okay? So I believe you can theoretically give us, we have the 15 million, I know everybody loves a million math here, but here we are, we have the 15 million and you drop from the 25, you can probably head down another 20 million. So we're looking at 35 million years just wandering around grabbing at fruit. That's incredible. 35 million years. The fruit is mine, honey. You can't have it. That's my tree. Get out of it. You know, all of that. 35 million years. That's in us. That is in us. That, you know, that claim. Of that's my fruit, that's my tree, those are my selections. So yeah, okay, so here we are human now. And do we share during those 35 million years? Well, do we share? It depends, you know, goes back to the whole, each group is a little different, and you know, look at the monkey family, a lot of the monkeys are different. These ones over there are very, very happy living in their high trees together, large family groups, a bunch of them at once. Other ones are just a strange family over there. Some are just separatists. So you have all kinds of different monkeys in the minds here. So when it comes to human, we're kind of like a mixture of all of them in a strange way. It's like some people are really communal, and they have to live around 100 people all the time in their life, and on the telephone. I have to have 100 people on call. And then others don't need anybody. So anyway, so now we get to the fun fruits like watermelon, and I'm like, well, how did they get into it? Because they didn't really have these metal tools, they didn't have the metal knives. So we're looking at bones. They use bones to stab into things. Possibly we're looking into rocks. They use rocks to break open the fruit to ripe. But obviously they didn't have the watermelon that is this perfect size, or that perfect cantaloupe, that perfect size. It would be like, wow, that it's there. Let's break it open, and it's small, a much smaller item. So it wouldn't have been a real mainstay, I don't believe. When we start looking at our domesticated fruits, which is more domesticated, we would have to actually say these large monster watermelons would not have been included. I would believe they would have been half size, even to a third. So, but they probably still ate the watermelons, you know, in their particular region. They just had to have the watermelons broken open with rocks. Okay, so that's really all I'm trying to say, is how we got at the fruit. We had the easy fruit, and now we have the more difficult fruit. So now we are coming, you know, out of this 35 million years, and we are starting to make ourselves like more tools. We need more tools to get into the fruit, you know, more tools. you know. So it's almost like tool adaptation, you know, more tools to, what was that thing that they did with the, they have that one monkey sticks that stick into the ant cage that they are, the ant mountain, and he puts a special saliva on it, and he puts it in there like a dipstick, and then he pulls it out, and then all of a sudden there he is, he has a stick filled with ants to gobble, or termites or whatever. So it's a very incredible moment, but not all the monkeys do that, and not all of the apes do that. They're just like, maybe that's just his deal. He has to eat. So that's not necessarily to say that all humans have to be eating termites or eating these ants. That's for that particular monkey. Okay. So anyway, So it's very exciting, all of this. You know, the being fruitarian, a frugivore, more and more, you know, being able to cut the fruit. And so here it is now. I've cut it. Now look at this. This is wonderful. So what happens to it? This is the rind, okay? So instead of throwing the rind away, what do? You compost. You compost it, okay? A very simple process. Anyway, so that's where I'm at, and we're just talking about the tool adaptation, how we all of a sudden in our diets, because I'm really on the food, right now, being more a mono moment for so many years. It was more of a mono moment with the food. You know, it's 35 million years, you know, it's just my banana. And I'm eating bananas right now, and I'm not eating bananas and mangoes. I might luck out, and maybe there's a mango tree nearby, but to have everything there all at once, even a large fruit salad, would have been unusual, you know, because we have these huge fruit salads. We have the strawberries and the bananas, and we have the peaches, and then we have the mango, and then we have the lemon squish. We have all of this together, but I mean, that's a kind of an unusual place to live, isn't it? You know, most monkeys would have never had that, most apes either. So that's what we're looking at, is that normal? Is that normal to have this buffet, this huge buffet of fruit salad? My grandma, she used to make one for like the holidays, and she put like the marshmallows in it and walnuts, and it was great, but it was completely like taboo. It was not really a healthy salad. It's very common though that people think of that as a fruit salad in certain areas of the United States, is to add marshmallows into it, and that's wrong. but when we're talking, what I'm really talking about is the bounty moment to have that many choices, because this is my dilemma now. You know, you go to the grocery store, and there are pears, there are apples, there are peaches, there are plums. You know, all of that at once, it would have been like, are we trying to walk into some Garden of Eden moment every day? I mean, it almost seems like too paradoxical. It seems like we are having too much in abundance. It would be wrong for, so our digestion system, back to our whole body digesting, is like wondering what? It's an intake of how much? You know, maybe I can't handle a strawberry and a grape all at once. Maybe it's just too much. Maybe I cannot handle blueberry and blackberries. Maybe we're not even on the same side of the continents. Maybe the blackberries come from the north and from the coastal area, and the blueberries come from the mountains. You know, maybe we're not supposed to eat them together. We may be able to acquire them in our now time with this traffic of importation, we can acquire all of these items, but it does not necessarily mean it's healthy. Just because it has such and such and as nutrient ingredient list, and this one also, and so everybody piles it all up into their nutrient ingredient list. I'm beginning to think, as an energy exponent, you may be doing yourself wrong. Maybe you, if you're gonna have energy correct, if you wanna live like, you know, be up there, what's that monkey in the, they're so cool. The ones, the snow monkeys, and they are living in where? The snow monkeys of Japan, way up there. They have their own special diet, you know, because they live off their own special fruit trees. Now, if they all of a sudden have blackberries from Oregon, it would be like a weirdness. You know, you're interrupting a weirdness. We have a lot of weirdnesses coming in all of a sudden, you know, from this world trade. And it all looks good. It all looks good on the stats, doesn't it? I need more calcium, or I need more this, or I need more that. But maybe we really don't. Maybe it's just about our energy feed, how we feed our energy to ourselves. I mean, do I have energy? Do I have to take a nap now for 4 hours a day? Or am I reducing to 2 hours? Am I reducing to one? Am I reducing to 15 minutes? You know, is this who you are? You know, are you detoxing? Or are you just stuck in what do we call it, that laissez-faire? And you cannot get out, you know, lethargy and all of it. So yeah, that's where I'm at right now. I'm kind of content with this, what do you call it? The diet that is, it's been going around for 35 million years. So, yeah, it's a long time. Anywho, it's tough because we like to eat the cooked foods also. We like to eat like cooked beans. That's so much easier to eat a cooked lentils than sprouting them. I am trying to make sprouted things, but I'm a disaster at it. I'm not good. So certain things are exponentially difficult. And we didn't, for those 35 million years, we didn't have those lentils and we didn't have those beans. We didn't. So, anyway, here we are now. Ta-da.